Maybe we could reflect a little today. I know this past 2 years has been crazy for me, so I'm sure that it's been crazy for you too. And, you know, I think we're all in this sort of time of life now where we're, you know, fingers starting to see the light at the end of the tunnel in some form of capacity. And what that really looks like for us. I feel as though the past 2 years, a lot of us have genuinely confused this idea of self-care. Because we felt like trapped, I guess, in this sort of world that we couldn't escape from. I think maybe sometimes it's time to take a step back and realize, okay, what is real self-care? What's really gonna help me take care of myself? And a lot of the time, that starts with sleep. So, you may be one of those people who adores sleep. Wait to go to bed at night because you know you're gonna have wonderful dreams, you're gonna feel cozy and calm. maybe one of those people that wakes up feeling refreshed and springs out of bed in the morning. Or you might be a bit more like me, who avoids going to sleep, which is strange to say, I guess, because once I'm in sleep, I feel calm and relaxed. Sleep a lot of the time is very, very difficult. I find my most productive time of day is in the middle of the night when everybody else is asleep. Not only because of my job, but also I tend to be one of those night owls where I'm procrastinating sleep, so I'll procrastinate the whole way throughout the day and save all of my tasks and my to-do list and energy till right before I go to bed. And I wonder if any of you do that too. It's almost as though I get anxious about the day ending and not feeling as though I've fulfilled it enough, but then I sort of postpone sleep as much as I possibly can because I dread the following day. It's almost like a vicious sort of cycle. But then, on the same note, once I get to sleep, it's beautiful, and then getting up in the morning again is really difficult. So I'm hoping that you are like the first type. But I think a lot of us are like the second. And it's thinking, okay, how can I add value to the sleep that I do get? So, whether it's watching or listening to ASMR videos, or your room is in the optimal comfort zone, so you have specific temperature that works for you, soft, fresh sheets, maybe calming music. Do you need some form of light, or do you need complete darkness? Little things like that. I personally like to sleep in the full dark, although for probably about 10 years of my life I was afraid to sleep in the complete dark, especially if I was on my own. So I would leave a side lamp on, or I would have my mum and dad leave a crack in the door with a lighting on, landing lighting on, could see a light. And then I would like fresh clean sheets, pajamas, but it has to be shorts pajamas because my legs get too hot in bed. And then the best would be when it was raining outside. Window outside. But I would never ever sleep with the window open because we lived right next to a wood and it was terrifying. Even though everybody else did and no one else had a problem, but I couldn't get in my brain to sleep with the window open. So it's about finding that sort of peaceful medium of where you like to sleep. Where is that perfect scenario, and how can you sort of tweak your lifestyle and your atmosphere around you to create the perfect sleep time for yourself? It might be that you sleep with a loved one as well. whether you prefer that or not, or whether you do or don't. You know, do they add value to your sleep or not? I think sometimes there is no shame in saying, for the benefit of our health, maybe we shouldn't sleep in the same room. Whether it's, you know, just for one night or if it's a full-time sort of deal. Sometimes my partner snores or breathes really loudly, or for some reason feels like a furnace. So on those occasions I'll go and sleep downstairs because I value both myself getting a good night's sleep and also not keeping him awake by staying on my phone next to him and disturbing him. And then we end up so much more peaceful and happy in the morning. So much a huge, huge part of self-care that we always forget. We have such busy, hectic lives that we always neglect our sleep. Always, always, always. And I know it can be so difficult, especially for those of you who are new moms or dads. And I, you know, applaud you as well. Being able to function day to day, you know. But it's so important to really, really plan out and prioritize those little moments, even if it's only half an hour. Think, okay, where can I put myself that's going to give me the best power naps, I guess. The same with nurses, doctors, these people that are working 12, 14 hour shifts a day, even more than that, at some point. And, you know, we can't pour from an empty cup, so we have to make sure that we are healthy ourselves in order to help others to be healthy. And that includes looking after people, but that also includes looking after our own families, our friends, the people in our care. We have to prioritize ourselves sometimes, and that can be really hard to do. Putting this video on today, you have taken a step to prioritizing yourself. You know, whether I am of great or of little help, we don't know how much help I can be to you. I hope I can be a lot. Regardless, you choosing to watch an ASMR video, specifically one that is intended for sleep, and to give yourself that attention, that personal attention, you are choosing to focus your attention onto you. And that's so important, and I applaud you for that. Hope that you give yourself a pat on the back for that, because a lot of the time we don't choose ourselves, and we really should. I have a funny little prop for you today. I did a role play just before. I'll be coming out later this week. Bit of a random one. And using in this roleplay that actually made some great sounds, so I thought it's very personal attention and a little bit of a spin on what I usually do. sort of a twist on face brushing, but it's silicone face brushing or face silicone brushing, face brushing with silicone, whatever you want to call it. I just thought it made such a great sound. That was a great visual too. I'm gonna be just brushing your face a little, and I want you to feel the tickly soft bristles on your face. Let it relax. Relaxing sensation. Face brushing, I think, is one of my favorite all-time personal attention triggers. This and things like measuring. Of course, I've mentioned self-care regarding sleep, but there's also a few different ways that we can also give us self-care. Those sorts of things would be like walks if we can, especially in less urban areas, so we can see some nature if possible. Cooking ourselves a balanced diet as best as is available to us, not for any particular fitness purposes, but purely for our bodily health, to make ourselves feel the best inside and help us feel nourished, even though things like chocolate and fast food can give us a lot of nourishment too, in soulful ways. They may not be most nutritious and balanced foods, but you can incorporate them in a healthy, balanced lifestyle and enjoy the good, soulful feel that indulgent food gives us, because self-care can sometimes be indulgent, and sometimes that is completely necessary, because we should be allowed to spoil ourselves, to feel extra bougie, like we're having a real treat with them. Find comfort in food. Can find comfort in sleep, comfort in those around. finish off with just a tiny little bit of Reiki, just to finish this personal attention for the evening. I'm just going to be removing some of your negative energy. Now, whether or not you choose to believe in energy transference is completely fine. If you don't believe in any of this, then simply take it as a kind gesture from me to you. And the intention of me trying to lift your burden and your weight from you, helping you to feel calmer and more relaxed. So you can choose to close your eyes if you wish, or watch the hand movements as I take some of the negative energy away from you. Quick positive warm energy transference to you as well from me, like a hug. I need to feel this energy, this warmth from me, as though it's a comforting hug from me to you. I want you to feel my presence and feel calmed by it. I hope that I've been able to help you feel compelled. Have a wonderful, wonderful, peaceful night's sleep. Thank you so much for joining me this evening. I hope you feel calm and at peace, ready to give yourself some self-care, prioritize your sleep and your restful atmosphere, giving yourself the highest priority and taking care of you first before others. If finding any opportunity you can to be caring towards yourself. And I hope that I've helped to brighten your evening and leave you feeling warm and calm for a nice, long, peaceful sleep. Sweet dreams.